A while ago, I went to the zoo to take some samples. One of the samples was from a yellow-green pool of water in the flamingo's enclosure. Let's see what I found. The green color of the sample is due to the presence of a lot of algae. And where there are algae, there are also other microorganisms that feeds on the algae. Some of these were rotifers, which are some of the smallest animals on the planet. The smallest are no more than 50 microns in size, but the largest species can reach a size where they are just visible to the naked eye. In this shallow, algae-filled body of water, the rotifers have all the food they can eat, and hardly any predators. When the conditions are so good for the rotifers, they are able to reproduce very fast and more than once in their relatively short lifespan. So most of the animals carry around one or more eggs. Here we can see one of the eggs hatching. Rotifers are more commonly known as wheel animals. This is due to the presence of tiny beading hair-like projections in front of the animal that kind of look like turning wheels. These microscopic animals are made up of over 1,000 cells, but I also found a lot of single-celled organisms in the water sample from the flamingos. These cells also have more than enough to eat. Most of them feed on bacteria and algae in the water. And inside each cell, you are able to see some of the different things they have ingested. Some of the ingested matter is currently being digested by the cells to unlock the chemical energy and nutrients, exactly like our digestion works. But not everything will be digested. Some cells have a symbiotic relationship with algae and let them live inside of the cell rent-free. This provides oxygen for the cells and nutrients for the algae. Even though flamingos are relatively large birds, the reason for their beautiful pink color is microscopic. In nature, the birds would feed on algae like these ones, or tiny crustaceans that feed on the red algae. The algae are called hematococcus and contains a red pigment called astaxanthin. When the flamingos ingest this molecule, it accumulates in its feathers, giving the birds their well-known pink color. So the next time you're at the zoo, remember that there's a lot more going on underneath the surface than meets the eye.